How you doing, folks? Your pal Joe with you once again to share with you a story. Not of birthday balloons, which you see that are prominently displayed in the back of my vehicle, because if you didn't know, several days ago it was my birthday. I'm still awaiting several cards and letters from each and every one of you. For some reason, I don't think that's going to happen. Anyways, I'm here to share with you a story about the time that I applied to become a professional wrestler at a professional wrestling school. That school, you ask? The ECW House of Hardcore, located in Long Island, New York. For those of you who know me, you'll know that my childhood dream was always to become a professional wrestler, ever since I was about 6 years old. So when I became of age to do so, I pursued that dream. ECW, on their television program, ran an advertisement for their training facility along with the telephone number. I jotted down the telephone number and made the call. I called the number, and the man who answers the telephone when I call this number is a man by the name of Taz. For those of you who don't know who Taz is, he was a huge star in ECW, a huge star in WWE, also did some color commentating for them, also did some color commentating for TNA, and currently has his own podcast. So Taz answers the phone. I say, yeah, you know, I saw your advertisement on the TV show. I want to become a professional wrestler. How do I go about doing so? He says, all right, you called the right place. It's a $150 application fee. And when do you want to come down? I said, how's Wednesday? Wednesday's fine. What time? How about 4 o'clock? 4 o'clock is good. Okay. Appointment set Wednesday, 4 o'clock. I continue talking with him to get some directions on how to get to the school. And people, keep in mind that this was the days before GPS, before Google Maps, and before MapQuest. So, needless to say, on my way to Long Island, I got a little lost. And that in turn forced me to run a little late. So I show up at the building, I walk in, it's about 4:15, and there is not a soul to be found. No one behind the desk, no one anywhere. Hello? Hello? No answer. There is, however, a door. And above this door, it says, do not enter. Well, upon looking for somebody for 2 to 3 minutes, I thought it was a good idea to enter this door that said, do not enter. I open the door, and much to my dismay, I see a 400-pound raging bull charging towards me. Who was that bull, you ask? That bull was Bubba Ray Dudley. My natural reaction, of course, while seeing this large man rushing towards me, was to back up. Whoa, 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 I said. He said, who are you? I said, I'm here, I have an appointment. He goes, you're Joe? I go, yeah. He goes, you're late. I said, I know. He goes, would you run into traffic? I said, that's exactly what happened. He said, all right, come with me. Come with him. We have a little sit down interview, shall we say. I discuss my submission wrestling background.
Yeah.
which I was assuming might impress him. It didn't. And upon the closing of this interview came the question that was not well received. You see, ECW, to attract potential students, they advertised that once you completed training of their wrestling school and you graduated, you would get a match on television, which you would be paid for. So, at the end of our interview, any more questions, he says? I said, yeah, actually, I do have one more question. I said, ECW says they will guarantee me a match on television, which I'll be paid for. And I'm wondering, how much am I going to get paid? Needless to say, this question did not go over well with Bubba Ray Dudley. His response was, bad question. And I was like, what do you mean, bad question? Why is that a bad question? Bad question. You haven't even laced up a pair of fucking boots yet, and you're wondering how much you're gonna get paid. Not much. Well, needless to say, I thought that was a little harsh at the time. But now, as I've gotten older, and in retrospect, he was 100% right. That was a bad question. I hadn't even laced up a pair of boots, hadn't even set foot in a ring yet, and I was wondering how much I was gonna get paid. And the question that I posed at the time was not meant in a disrespectful manner, mind you. It was more so just to see how much I would have gotten paid once graduation was over. Maybe something to look forward to, you know what I mean? But again, probably not the best question to ask at the time. In retrospect, it's probably a good thing I didn't go to their school, because I probably would have gotten the living shit kicked out of me because of that damn question. Wants to know how much he's getting paid for his televised match that he's not gonna have. That deserves an extra hour of ass beating.
You don't have my respect. You're nothing and a nobody in my industry.
So we shook hands. He gave me a receipt for the $150, and if I did decide to go back there, that $150 would be credited towards my tuition.
I'm a bad person who does bad things. Put your tail between your legs and leave.
As we're leaving, our good friend Taz is walking in the building. I shake hands with him. I say hello to him briefly. And then I leave. Unfortunately for me, the job I had at the time did not pay well. I'm a loser, baby. I was trying to save money, and by the time I got a little bit of money saved, the ECW House of Hardcore went out of business. So that was my story about visiting the ECW House of Hardcore and visiting with our good friends Bubba Ray Dudley and Taz, and a question that probably shouldn't have been asked at the time. Folks, I hope you enjoyed this story, and thank you for listening. These roads suck. Have a good day.